and 30th of April. Again, refinancing of nearly 29,500 crores has been provided by the NABARD to all the cooperative banks and the regional rural banks so that they can have onward lending done. And this has happened just in March. Just only in March, NABARD has refinanced 29,500 crores through the rural cooperative banks and the rural regional rural banks. Then again, you know, rural infrastructure, also through a fund which is operated by the NABARD, is the RIDF, which is the Rural Infrastructure Development Fund. Through this, only again in March 2020, a support of 4,200 crores has been provided for rural infrastructure. So rural areas and their infrastructure work is also being provided for in March alone to the extent of 4,200 crores, and that's happened during the COVID period. And finally, state governments do also get working capital assistance, and to the extent of 6,700 crores have been sanctioned for them to procure agricultural produce, which means they can take things from the farmer, they can provide things to the farmer, and when they procure agricultural produce, that money goes into the hands of the farmers themselves. And what is the amount there? 6,700 crore as working capital was sanctioned for state agencies to do the agricultural produce procurement. That again is money going into the hands of the people in the ground, particularly in the rural areas. I'll go over to the urban poor, but before that, in Hindi.
कृषि के क्षेत्र में, क्योंकि आपको पता है पिछला सीजन भी दो महीने देश के लिए भी और देश के कृषि की अर्थव्यवस्था के लिए बहुत महत्वपूर्ण था, तो उसके लिए पिछले मार्च और अप्रैल महीने में 63 लाख ऋण मंजूर किए गए, जिसकी लगभग जो अमाउंट है वो 86,600 करोड़ रुपया है, और इससे बल कृषि क्षेत्र को मिला है, विशेष तौर पर किसान के लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है। गांव में कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, रूरल रीजनल रूरल बैंक, इनकी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका रहती है, और कोऑपरेटिव बैंक और रीजनल रूरल बैंक को मार्च 2020 में नाबार्ड ने 29,500 करोड़ रुपया के रीफाइनेंस का प्रावधान किया है। ग्रामीण क्षेत्र में आधारभूत ढांचे के विकास के लिए 4200 करोड़ रुपये का सहयोग रूरल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट फंड के माध्यम से राज्यों को ये मार्च में राशि उपलब्ध करवाई गई। इसके अलावा जो फसल की खरीद, कृषि उत्पाद की खरीद के लिए 6700 करोड़ रुपये की वर्किंग कैपिटल भी, कार्यशील पूंजी भी राज्यों को उपलब्ध करवाई गई है।
I spoke about the rural areas, rural poor, rural money reaching the hands of the farmers and so on. Now I just very quickly mention about urban poor. In just the last 2 months, again, during the COVID period, again, what activity has happened to reach out to the urban poor, which includes migrants? Government of India has permitted state governments to utilize State Disaster Response Fund, which goes from the center, for setting up shelter for migrants and providing them food and water. Just rough estimate that I'm giving you, 11,000 crores were sent in that name through the SDRF, with which they run the shelter homes, with which they give them food, with which they take care of them. And that money was also sent from the center. Of course, states do have a right, but that was given. And using that money, many of the migrants have been attended to. So I want that to be kept in context when we talk about attending to the migrants. Again, there are shelter homes which are under the shelter for urban homeless category. That is something which normally is there. But in those shelter for urban homeless, 3 meals are provided entirely at the cost of the central government. So homeless who live in urban areas, particularly in the COVID situation, are getting 3 meals per day. And I'm not saying this as though, oh, we've done this. I'm saying more from the point of view of we are conscious. We are attending to the migrants and we are giving them in various different ways. Food, taking care of them in the shelters, reaching cash to them. All this has been done and therefore I'm enumerating. And did I do this some other time last year? No. I am showing you what has happened in the last 2 months, the critical lockdown period. So in shelter homes, 3 meals are being provided for people who are urban homeless. Now, the other thing, you may recall when the Prime Minister addressed the nation, how India's capacities can be utilized so that we can serve the globe and how those capacities are lying dormant and we are the ones who have to give the stimulus, all of us will have to. 12,000 self-help groups all over the country. This is an example which Honorable Prime Minister referred to. 12,000 SHG groups have produced over 3 crore of masks and 1.20 lakh liters of sanitizers, again during this COVID period. And the self-help groups in urban centers are with urban poor. So urban poor are contributing also in this COVID period. And self-help groups, as you know, is something which is supported by the central government also. Another experiment which was successful is for disbursing revolving funds to the SHGs, and these revolving funds for the self-help groups have also become on board a Paisa portal. It is called PA, all in capital, I is small, and SA, Paisa portal, as of April. And now many state governments, seeing the pilot project which had happened in Gujarat, want their people also to get onto this, and through this, a lot of across the state benefits which they can get will be available for the SHGs. And lastly, for the urban poor, 7,200 new SHG groups have been formed, newly formed for the urban poor, and that commenced from 15th March. Critical COVID time. New self-help groups for whom assistance get given and they get benefit from revolving funds and so on to catch on with what they want to do for their livelihoods. So during these 2 months, COVID period, you have these activities which have happened with central government participating actively in these 2 months only.
प्रवासी मजदूर और शहरी गरीब, ये चर्चा का विषय पिछले कुछ दिनों में भी रहा, लेकिन मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ, हमारी सरकार ने पिछले वर्षों में भी इनके लिए किया और इस समय में तो विशेष तौर पर हम लोगों ने आपदा राहत के माध्यम से जो फंड स्टेट डिजास्टर रिस्पांस फंड के माध्यम से उपलब्ध, उनको हमने राज्यों को करवाया, ये लगभग 11,000 करोड़ रुपये से ज़्यादा है, ताकि इन लोगों को उसमें से राहत दी जा सके, आपदा राहत हो सके, उसके लिए इस्तेमाल किया गया। और यही नहीं, हाइजीन का ख्याल रखते हुए 3 मील्स एक दिन में प्रति व्यक्ति के लिए इन शेल्टर होम्स में उपलब्ध करवाई गई, ऐसा प्रावधान वहां पर करवाया गया। और जो हमारे स्वयं सहायता समूह हैं, जिसको आप सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स भी कहते हैं, ऐसे 12,000 स्वयं सहायता समूह ने 3 करोड़ मास्क और 1,20,000 लीटर सैनिटाइजर्स का उत्पादन किया है। ये एक अपने आप में बहुत बड़ी बात है और ये संकट की घड़ी में हमारे काम और ये बड़ा काम देश के लिए स्वयं सहायता समूह की हमारी बहनों ने किया है। यही नहीं, 7,200 नए स्वयं सहायता समूह इस समय में बनकर और शुरू हैं पिछले 2 महीनों में। और जो रिवॉल्विंग फंड सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप के लिए पैसा एक पोर्टल के माध्यम से हमने शुरू किया था गुजरात में पायलट प्रोजेक्ट, अब उसको पूरे देश भर के अलग अलग राज्यों में शुरू किया जाएगा ताकि इनको और लाभ मिल सके। आपको याद होगा कुछ दिन पहले जब हमने घोषणा की थी तो सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप के लिए भी 10 लाख से बढ़ाकर 20 लाख रुपए उसकी लिमिट कर दी थी, तो इससे भी उनकी कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग में मदद मिलेगी।
दिस